Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Charts and Graphs from Q. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel, episode 1406, Create the Chart. Well, hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Gillen. This is a four-part podcast series on someone completely new to charts. We're in step two. Yesterday, episode 1405, we took some data in Word, some text from Word, and set up our data in Excel. Now, remember, we want to have labels going across the top row, labels going down the left-hand side. We didn't do this because we were typing the data from Word, but if you're getting data from somewhere else, it's very likely that there's a label up here in that top left corner cell. It's very important to choose that cell, press the delete key to make that be blank. That's the key to having your charts work. A lot of the time, we'll select all of the data to be charted, and we go to the Insert tab. Now, here we're comparing two different populations of people, or actually a subset of the entire population of people over time. I hope to have time going across the bottom, and we're going to compare. As you go to the Insert tab, there's a bunch of different dropdowns here. As you go to these various dropdowns, you're going to see a repeating pattern over and over and over again. They always show up in sets of three. The first one is called a clustered chart. That's where we're comparing two different values. Then a stacked chart, where we're putting the values on top of each other. It's not what we want to do here. And then 100% stacked, where it always adds up to 100%. And you'll see this repeat again and again and again. Same thing here in the column chart. Those three different icons appear. You'll see that all the time. Even in a line chart, they do the same thing. So here we're comparing two. Here we're stacking two. Here we're stacking two. And the second one always adds up to 100% every time. So we want the clustered column chart. Click OK. And look how simple that is. We get a chart. Beautiful. Okay, now, if you're new to charts, one thing I want you to be aware of, look up here in the right-hand corner of the ribbon. So you usually have data, review, view. You probably don't have developer, probably don't have evidence, might not have power pivot, and then it just ends. But now that we have a chart and the chart is selected, design, layout, and format, all of your charting tools are here. But what's very frustrating, it's very likely that you're going to come back to this worksheet, or you're just going to click out of the chart, and look, all of those charting tools have disappeared. So to get to the charting tools, you have to make sure to click on the chart. I don't agree with this decision by Microsoft. I've had arguments with the guy from Microsoft, but that's the way it is. You have to click on the chart or you lose the tools. All right, now let's talk about some things that I don't like about this chart that we can start to fix tomorrow. First thing is the scale. It's looking like the employees who took PowerExcel did dramatically better. They did 6 points better, but they didn't do like a whole third better, and that's because they've zoomed in on the scale. And this is a decision Microsoft makes. We'll talk about that tomorrow. Some other things I would like to fix. Well, we need a title. The legend is taking up way too much space over here. I have a great solution for that. And red. Red is just negative. Why do they always choose red for the second color in most charts? Is just beyond me. So we'll take a look at fixing those in episodes 1407 and 1408. So, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. See you next time for another Netcast.